Welcome to EEMS 130, Part 1. This video provides a brief overview of some of the most commonly used visualization features of the EFDC Explorer modeling system. In Part 1, we will describe the cell map and 2D plan views. Let's get started. The cell map is helpful for understanding the arrangement of cells in a model and for modifying the arrangement of cell blocks. There are several options for viewing cell maps at the top of the window in the Colored By drop-down menu, as well as in the buttons next to it. The Colored By drop-down menu allows the viewing of cells by color with three options including active cells, cell codes, and MPI subdomains. If the active cells option is selected, the cell map will be shown with different colors assigned to the active cells and inactive cells. If cell codes is selected, then the cell map is visualized by the type of cell. If the model domain is divided into subdomains to run with the EFDC Plus MPI, then the cell map will be illustrated with different colors assigned to the different MPI subdomains. The user can zoom to the full extent of the cell map. The pan button can be used to move around the cell map by clicking and holding. The select button can be used to select a single grid cell. Cells can also be selected by grid block. By default, the cell map will always be displayed with uniform dimensions. To display the cells in a non-uniform way, the Toggle Grid Uniform View button can also be used. Similarly, the grid lines can be toggled using the Toggle Grid Lines button. The magenta bounding box around cell blocks can be toggled on and off using the Toggle Grid Blocks button. Cell connectors can be shown using the Show Cell Connections button. The legend can also be toggled on and off in the cell map view. The I and J index labels can be adjusted for readability using the label step value. The Auto Arrange Grid Blocks button can be used to automatically arrange the grid block positions so that it can be used for an MPI run. The Trim Grid Top Row button can be used after rearranging a grid block to remove some unnecessary rows of cells. The 2D plan view is the most commonly used two-dimensional visualization tool in EFDC Explorer. Let's take a brief tour through this powerful feature. There are two ways to open a 2D plan view window. The first is on the main menu under the 2DH view menu. The other is on the toolbar using the 2DH button. Under the Change View submenu, there are four options to help users move around the model domain in the 2D plan view. The Zoom to Rectangle button will allow users to change the view extent by using the mouse to draw a box around the desired plan view extent. The Pan Shift button can be used to pan around the model domain by clicking and holding the left mouse button while moving the mouse. Holding the Shift button and clicking and moving with the right mouse button will allow users to pan in the plan view without activating this button. By default, the mouse wheel can also be used to zoom in and out. The Previous View button can be used to quickly revert to the previously used plan view extent and area. The View Full Extent button can be used to quickly reset the view to the full extent of the model domain. There are also a variety of options for viewing and editing the properties of one or many cells at a time. The cell information will display information about a cell when it is selected in the 2D plan view. The Edit Cells Property button will open a window which can be used to edit the properties of the selected cell. The Copy Cell Properties button can be used to quickly copy and paste values or changes within the selected cell by using the left and right mouse buttons. The 2D plan view has powerful features for selecting cells in a very flexible way. For example, you can select a single individual cell with a mouse click. Using the Control or Shift buttons in conjunction, you can select multiple cells in different ways. The Line Crossing button can be used by creating two nodes and selecting all of the cells along the straight line between those nodes. The user can also select all cells in a rectangle by clicking and dragging. A polygon can also be drawn in the plan view using the left mouse button to create a node of a polygon and the right mouse button to close the polygon. Simple text files can also be used to select cells crossing a polyline inside a polygon or at defined points. The Using Criteria button allows the selection of cells using parameters and a criteria such as greater than, less than, or equal to for a certain value entered by the user. The current selection can be inverted, cleared, saved to a text file, or loaded from an existing text file. The 2D plan view has features to generate polylines and point layers on the fly. These overlay layers can be imported and exported using common text and shapefile formats. Using the Draw Polylines button, the user can create a polyline in the plan view. Nodes are created by clicking the left mouse button, and the polyline can be completed by clicking the right mouse button. Users can delete polylines with a click using the Delete Polyline button. Once created, the user can insert, delete, and move nodes along the path of a polyline. River mile labels can also be added along a selected polyline. Or generated based on selected cells using the cell centroids as nodes. Polyline layers can be created, loaded, and saved from the 2D plan view using the menu. The Layer Control menu allows users to add, remove, and rearrange the draw order of layers in the 2D plan view. The Layer Control menu can be used to add a new layer from the model input and output files, or an external file like a shapefile, save and load plan view layouts, or turn all layers on or off. The visibility of each layer can be toggled by clicking the light bulb symbol next to each layer. Cell information for the selected layer can be displayed in the plan view by toggling the cursor symbol next to each layer. Layers can be unlocked for editing by toggling the pencil symbol next to each layer. Labeling in the 2D plan view can be turned on or off for each layer using the label toggle. Any timing frames, scale bars, north arrows, or layers that have been set in the 2D plan view can be saved and loaded at another time without adjustment of the components. This is especially useful when working with multiple versions of the same model, and for creating consistent animations or visualizations. To load the layout which was saved in the past, click on the Load Layout button. If the saved layout also includes layers, however the layer is not in the current view, the user should check Load Layer Settings checkbox. When there are a number of layers in the layer control, the user might want to arrange the draw order of the layers by selecting the layer first and then using the up and down arrows to change the draw order. Pressing the right mouse button on any of the layers in the layer control will allow users to access that layer's properties, zoom to the extent of the layer, edit, export, or remove that layer. The Properties menu for a layer is used to adjust the display settings of a selected layer. Let's take a look at how new model layers can be added to the 2D plan view. The primary group organizes the model layers for model properties and outputs. Let's filter by the velocities primary group. Once a primary group filter has been applied, the parameter list will be populated by parameters within that primary group. Additional configuration options, depending on the primary group and parameters selected, can be seen in the lower part of the dialog. The Layer Properties dialog allows users to edit the general information and display properties of the layer. For the visualization of any cell property, the color ramp and range of values can be customized or allowed to vary with the extent of the 2D plan view window. Any layer in the 2D plan view can be exported to other formats, including XYZ delimited files, text, tech plot files, shape files, or Google Earth KML files.